Hello everyone, I am Manisha Sahu from SBIFS Indore and my topic is development of latent fingerprints by chemical methods and various type of chemical detection of fingerprint methods. Three types of fingerprint impressions: patent fingerprints, visible prints left on smooth surface when blood, ink or some other liquids come into contact with hands and is transferred to the surface. Number 2, plastic fingerprints. Actual indentation left in some soft material like clay. Number 3, latent fingerprints. Fingerprints that are invisible to the naked eyes and caused by transfer of oils and other bodily secretion onto a surface. They can be made visible by various different methods. So now we can discuss about various types of different methods of developing fingerprint. Firstly, I gave brief introduction to you. The chemical detection of latent fingerprints involve introduction of chemical that will react to a print constituent's chemical such as amino acids, glucose, lactic acid, etc. Ninhydrin. Ninhydrin reacts with amino acid in sweat from purple blueprints. A 0.6% solution in ethanol is sprayed onto porous surface such as paper. In this method, ninhydrin is a chemical that is often used in fingerprinting. Ninhydrin is usually dissolved in a solvent. In this case, the solvent that is ninhydrin was dissolved in was ninhydrin reacts with amino acids left with the fingerprints in order to show them in a blue-purple color. This structure is the chemical structure of ninhydrin, and ninhydrin technique is used in bank forgery, etc. Second method is physical developer. Silver nitrate based liquid reagent used on porous surface. It is often used as last resort because it destroys protein. Physical development is a method for detection of fingerprint. It is a technique for process which is present in crime scene, which is porous in nature, including paper, cardboard, clay item, and currency notes. These are the chemicals which is involved in chemical detection. Next method is luminol method, a chemical that reacts with hemoglobin to produce the phenomena of chemiluminescence. Can be fireless, it means can be sprayed where nothing is visible under UV light, blood or liquefied fluids glow. Next technique is iodine filming. It is one of the oldest latent print development methods. Solid iodine crystals sublimate and the vapor will react with fatty oils and some sweat residue. Iodine prints are not permanent and will begin to fade once the filming process can be used on porous and non-porous surface. Iodine technique, it gives sharp impressions on documents. The advantage of this technique is that its filming is nature. When we apply it or solid or liquid for detection of latent fingerprint, the number of ridges get disturbed. Next is gelatin violet. It is used for developing latent prints on the adhesive side of tape. An aqueous solution of crystal violet is sprayed directly onto the adhesive. Next technique was amido black technique. It is a protein dye stain that can develop faint body, bloody fingerprints on porous and non-porous surface. Blood must be swabbed prior to amido black application for any DNA analysis. Amido black is a protein staining reagent that is commonly used for enhancement and visualization of suspected blood stain pattern evidence. And next one is LCV. Leukocrystal violet, a protein stain spray that can develop faint or invisible bloody fingerprints on the non-porous surface. LCV is a coloring reagent for blood that is based on the blood catalyzed reaction of hydrogen peroxide with LCV, whereby the colorless LCV is oxidized to the purple crystal violet. And also there are many number of chemical developers like sticky side powder, black yellow 40, dab, diaminobenzenate formula, small particles reagent used on wet surfaces such as plastics or coated surfaces. There are various techniques for extracting developed latent prints, like photographs, covering the print to preserve it entirely, lifting the prints with adhesive tape and placing the tape when prints on the card with label. Thanks for watching my video.